In the program Current Affairs Now, we bring you a discussion on Prime Minister's South Africa and Mozambique visit. The participants are Professor Sachin Chaturvedi, Director General Research and Information System for Developing Countries, Malancha Chakravarti, Observer Research Foundation, and Samrat Bandhopadhyay, AIR correspondent, who initiates and moderates the discussion.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi is on a four-nation visit to Africa. He has visited Mozambique and has arrived in South Africa and is having hectic parleys. Mr. Narendra Modi said, Mozambique is the gateway of India's investment in Africa as one-fourth of the investment to Africa is related to Mozambique. Secretary Economic Relations inked three MOUs with Government of Mozambique in the area of sports for youth, control of drug trafficking, production and trade of pulses. How do you perceive this visit of Prime Minister?
This is a very important visit and also is in line with India's close ties with Africa, which have developed since the India-Africa Forum Summit last year. Now, you've mentioned about the three MOUs, and out of that particularly, the pulses production and export is one of the most important, particularly because we in India have been short of pulses.
Professor Chaturvedi, what is your opinion?
I think there are two or three developments which are extremely important for us to see when Prime Minister is in Mozambique. Number one definitely is the idea of security partnership that we are looking at the macro level, not only in context of Mozambique's role vis-à-vis Indian Ocean, but also in its own earnestness in terms of how Mozambique is going to partner with us in Africa. So that, I think, is extremely important. Second, and much more important collaboration that we have strike at and is continuation of our cooperation in the realm of science and technology. This is extremely important. Early this year, India finished a major project in Mozambique to produce solar panels, and now Prime Minister has given a major boost to cooperate with them in their National Center for Science and Technology. So that is extremely important for India and Africa and India and Mozambique.
What is your opinion on the agreement with regards to pulse production and trade? Will it enhance the capacity building in pulses and reduce pulse import reliance of India? And is it sustainable in long run?
What is happening in India is that pulses, which are a major source of proteins for India, we have been traditionally ignoring the production within India, which is why now we have to look for external sources. And Africa emerges as an important source. So within that, all these countries, not just Mozambique, even Tanzania, Kenya, these are coming up as important sources of pulses for India.
And is it sustainable in long
term? It is sustainable because, firstly, because of the nature of how we want to source pulses. We've gone for a long-term arrangement with these countries. So from our side, we would want a long-term source. But from the other side, India is also instituting some domestic measures to improve the MSP, etc., within the country to increase the production. But pulses are a critical area for India.
India and Mozambique are members of the Indian Ocean Dream Association, IORA. The organization includes countries bordering the Indian Ocean. South Africa, Tanzania, Kenya are members too of this association. Considering the strategic location of the Indian Ocean, how do you see the trade, investment, security aspects associated with this region?
Absolutely right. I think we should not forget that in Prime Minister's visit to Mozambique is not just a bilateral visit. It's extremely important given the fact that next year, IORA, Indian Ocean Rim Association, would be meeting at the level of the heads of the state. So the summit that would be there in Indonesia next year, early part of the next year, is going to be at the level of the heads of the state. Prime Minister Modi and his government has come up with a major program, what is being called as Blue Economy Program.
India and Mozambique share common cultural association. What are the salient areas of collaboration with regards to culture?
Now, I'm glad you spoke about this, you know, because this is particularly important in the light of some of the unfortunate race attacks that have happened, and not only in the context of India's relations with Mozambique, but with whole of Africa. That culture needs to play a very important role in our relationship with Africa. So we cannot bypass the issue of people-to-people relations and only speak about trade and investment. These things are important, but culture needs to be at the center of discussions between India and Africa.
Professor Chaturvedi, you want to talk about this?
No, certainly. I think with our foreign minister, External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj has very clearly articulated a paradigm shift in our approach on our diplomacy. And there she says three C's are extremely important and culture is definitely one of them. So they are trying to now combine economic trade diplomacy with culture. And that's the emphasis that is there. So from that point of view, certainly the idea is to address our culture more in the context of our current engagement, but also to bring in concepts related to trade engagement or economic diplomacy.
Both countries have a democratic tradition. There are plans of frequent exchanges between the parliamentarians to study and learn the working of the parliament. How do you view this initiative?
This is, again, another welcome development because, you know, many a times, like I was just trying to mention a little while ago, that engagements of the top leadership are the ones which attract the maximum attention. But they need to be built from the ground level. So greater interaction between Indian parliamentarians with their African counterparts would be a welcome development.
Professor Chaturvedi, on this?
Absolutely right. Capacity building for parliamentarians is something that India can definitely undertake. At the parliament, we have the capacity to provide training to parliamentarians from other systems. We have not only developed the system that we inherited from British Parliament, we have also strengthened it. Now our speaker has launched a Speaker's Research Initiative, which is another important example of how we are doing innovations within our system. And there have been several such experiments. So I think the current proposal of our Prime Minister to Mozambique in Parliament to send young parliamentarians and form a joint study group by the two parliaments is extremely important. And I think it would also open up new vistas for our engagement with African countries in terms of not only engaging them with the democratic processes, but also strengthening institutions. And mind it that this is another major plank for us in Africa. We are trying to support institutions. It's not just for trade or investment we are in. We are also supporting their development endeavors, their efforts to strengthen institutions, not only at the highest level, we discussed the parliament, but also in trade, in investment, in technology. I gave you example of solar panel production unit. So when that solar panel was being supported by India, India provided training to 25 scientists from Mozambique. They came, spent 1 year here, and are now self-dependent in terms of producing solar panels. They came to our public sector enterprises here, got trained, and are back. So like that, our ITEC flagship programs, our Parliament's program for capacity building, Ministry of Home Affairs program, also our security establishment, they are also providing them training. So capacity building is a major effort from India, but along with that, India is also trying to build their institutions so that they become important. And from that point of view, India supporting institution development in Africa, and now in case of Mozambique, as we are discussing, three institutions Prime Minister has announced support for. One is the National Science and Technology Center. Second is this idea of parliamentarian institution, the parliament itself in terms of training and capacity building. And third, and I think very important, is the security establishment, training for them. So all the three are being addressed. And from that point of view, it's continuation of what we heard at the India-Africa Forum Summit, which was here a couple of months back, mm-hmm. where India announced setting up of 21 such institutions all across Africa. We have kept $7 million aside for this, and that is an extremely important contribution from India for our partners from Africa.
What are the overall strategic collaboration opportunities for India with regard to trade, investment, economic development of the region?
Actually, economics now is playing a very important role with regard to India's engagement in Africa. And India's trade with Africa has boomed in recent years. and much of the growth will come from these two places. So in terms of specific areas, if you would want me to talk about, I would say that the key sectors are energy, firstly. Now, energy, a lot of times we tend to believe that India's interest lies only in sourcing oil or gas from there. But it's, the dynamics is much more complex than that, because we import a lot of oil and then we also export refined oil. So our interest in Africa is not only to just take the oil, but also as an exporter of more refined oil. Another area that we just touched upon was agriculture, and we spoke of pulses, which are of course very important, particularly in the context of Mozambique. But again, here Africa is also a major export market for India's rice. So India is an important agricultural exporter for many of the African countries. Apart from these two sectors, pharma is another very important sector. India has played a very important role in providing access to medicines, particularly in the context of AIDS, to poor people in Africa. So, and another sector which is growing, that is the auto sector. Here, I think India's Make in India has a huge impact, and we auto sales in African countries have shown an increase, and this is another sector which will grow much more rapidly in the future.
Well, you spoke about the number of energy companies, basically, and also infrastructure organizations are eager to set up their base in Africa, particularly in the energy sector, and also more so in Mozambique and South Africa. Professor Chaturvedi, your opinion on this?
I think first we should see the investment in trade linkages. I think extremely important for us to realize that India's engagement in Mozambique has deepened over the years. And if we see the numbers, the investment from 2007-2008 to 2014-15 has expanded from almost $8 million to something like $24 million. And for a country like Mozambique to have investment from India of range of $24 million is quite some, given the fact that our trade has expanded only from something like $25 million to something like $400 million. And this expansion in last 7 years is quite sizable. And this is important given the fact that Mozambique is not a major recipient of our lines of credit. So somebody saying that there is a direct connection between our development cooperation and our trade and investment is not correct. That is extremely important for us to bear in mind. Second important dimension here is the composition of this trade and investment basket. Already we discussed pharmaceuticals and oil, which are extremely important. We should also see the rising import from India of manufacturing sector goods that are growing from Mozambique's point of view. And this is largely because a major push that has been given now in India to electronics sector. Our electronics production and export in last 14 months has expanded in a major way. And several of the African countries are major importers of these new products that we are exporting. So this changing basket of our export composition is very important for our linkages with these countries.
You mean the forward as well as other linkages?
The backward linkages within the sector. We are trying to streamline our own Make in India and Digital India kind of initiatives that are there. They are trying to provide fillip, and the sector which has come up quite handy in this is the electronic sector. Whole semiconductor-based industry development we all were eyeing for, they have got a huge jump in last 1 year or so.
The Beira port in Mozambique is an important strategic trade point for exports to Malawi, Zimbabwe, Zambia, and other countries. What is your analysis on trade facilitation via this strategic port for more trade and investment, and also to encourage people-to-people contact?
I think this is extremely important because given the new priority, as I mentioned to you a little while ago, in terms of blue economy, this is an important dimension where India has taken up 31 ports to be developed. There is a proposal to have from this port liquefied gas to be coming to our eastern port, where several of our entrepreneurs are investing for port development in Orissa. So in Orissa, there are proposals to develop two major ports from where Mozambique would get the gas. And once this gas arrives, and thanks to the initiatives that our petroleum ministry and the minister has launched in the recent past, Odisha may emerge as a major hub for refining petroleum that we would be importing from Mozambique. There are several agreements already signed, and as part of our IORA efforts, there would be a possibility that this oil would not only be exported back to Mozambique for their consumption, but would also be exported to our eastern side of the IOR rim. So the countries that may get benefited are Bangladesh, Myanmar, and further down to Thailand and others. So IORA would emerge as a major rim to provide support to this, and from that point of view, support to Beira Port is extremely important. It is important in terms of facilitating entry and exit of the big ships, and as of now, the capacity to have them there is simply not there. And I think India is becoming now far more insightful in terms of bringing some of these security issues back on the table. And from that point of view, India's presence at the ports in Mozambique is very crucial.
What could be the initiatives by the Indian government to enable FDI investment to and from India by global investors and Indian organizations in the area of coal, iron ore and minerals?
Now, these three things that you've mentioned, coal, iron ore and minerals in general, are very important for India. Coal from South Africa is critical for us. Now, much of the Indian diplomacy has often been termed as energy diplomacy because we are a critically energy deficient country. So our companies have also invested in Africa, but I am not extremely positive about the success that they have met, because also Africa's energy sector is a very competitive sector, something that we must be careful about. Now, you have many big players there, and one of the biggest players that has emerged is China. So here is, we have to be very careful in our approach here, and in a few instances, particularly in Angola, ONGC was not very successful. So this is an area which is critical to us, but we have to be very, very cautious, careful, alert when we're talking about this sector.
Professor, would your opinion on this, as well as bring out the context you'd like to talk about in terms of the approach of China vis-a-vis India in terms of the development model that they are trying to achieve?
At the macro level, if you identify, both of us are committed by certain principles which are led by the overarching principles of South-South cooperation. So from that point of view, definitely there are not many distinctions. If you go by a very Western academic approach, they try to draw out as if China and India are in Africa for resources alone. The issues related to the distinctions between India and China are important. And there I would say the idea is in terms of participation of the country. And again, I would give you an example of what we see in terms of Mozambique's participation. The effort that India has made to develop the port to bring back the crude oil here, refine it and give it back to the country from where it is coming in, is a clear sense of participation for Mozambique. It's a win-win situation for both the countries. There are certain instances for China, but I would also appreciate that China has also helped in several ways countries. So I think no parallel are to be drawn, because the level at which they are operating, we are far away from that.
Now, I think, you know, the last point that Sachin made about there being no comparison, because the levels are very different. Indeed, even if we look at either China's trade with the continent or China's investment or China's development finance in Africa, it is huge. So I thought it was very important to say that this China-Africa competition in Africa, which is being spoken about too much in the media, is actually ignoring the fact that the scale of China's operations and engagement is very different. For instance, China has been very successful in Africa's energy sector, and much of it is because of the huge signature bonuses that it has been able to provide, which India certainly doesn't have the deep pockets to get to the same level.
Indian diaspora is quite enthusiastic of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit to South Africa. On a global context, what is its significance?
There is a great significance, certainly, and Pravasi Bharati is a major policy plan of this government right from the beginning. As Prime Minister very categorically said, in terms of how we look at the role Indian diaspora may play, and he was very emphatic in terms of spending more time with them, but also trying to articulate the position that they are the ones who have shaped global imagination when we talk of Indian diaspora. Immediately after our independence in 1947, the first Indian government sent a major delegation led by Kaka Kalelkar and others to see how Indian diaspora is placed. And then somehow it was not on our radar for several decades. It was brought back in 2000 when Vajpayee was the Prime Minister. And then we find now a greater scope, possibility and potential for contribution from Pravasi Bharati here, but also our ability to connect with some of these communities and their growing interest in Indian affairs and being part of India's growth story. So from that point of view, the role of our community in Africa is extremely important. They are thoroughly engaged in their own national affairs there, but of course have soft corner for India and greater inclination to remain connected with India's growing profile at the global level.
How do you see the potential of Rovuma Basin in Mozambique in terms of natural gas export to India? And also for the geopolitical point of view, how do you analyze the bilateral and multilateral relation of India with African and countries like Saudi Arabia with respect to natural gas and petroleum trade to India?
Like I mentioned in the beginning, it is all these countries are extremely important for India's energy security. Now, towards the last part of your question, when you said that, you know, how it is related to Saudi Arabia and Qatar, I am not very sure as to India's energy sector is evolving in a complex manner. Now, Africa's share in India's energy imports has increased dramatically, and it will continue to increase very dramatically. And gas, of course, is a major part of our energy basket. And at some level, you know, Saudi Arabia still is the largest source of oil for us. As far as I understand India's energy sector, our aim is to diversify our source to the extent possible. So Africa is very important, but all these other countries will continue to remain important.
There are two or three things I think we should keep in mind. Number one, we tried for pipe gas and TAPI couldn't go any further. Then we tried undersea pipelines coming from Oman and supplying gas here. That has also not worked. So then we go further down and we find Mozambique as the most reliable partner in terms of supply of liquefied gas. And this is easy to ship. And as I was saying, with Mozambique, not only in the port, not only offshore, but onshore development of this is a major priority area for India. Ministry of Petroleum in Government of India has made several initiatives, and the development of the valley is extremely important initiative of them to connect the supply with Indian shores. And as I said, idea is to bring them on the eastern side of our port line. And from that point of view, India's efforts to develop bilateral relationship assumes greater geopolitical significance. Why? Because if the capacities are being developed on our eastern coast, then we have ability to ensure energy security for our neighbors as well. Myanmar, Bangladesh definitely would be two major beneficiaries of this initiative, which would provide a major support in terms of their dependence on China for a number of these activities. It would also reduce our dependence on Pakistan to play an important role in terms of allowing the pipeline that we have all been waiting all this while. The continued entry of China in Central Asia is another sort of cause of concern for our growing dependence on Central Asia for diversification of our energy sources. So given this larger geopolitical context, both in our immediate neighborhood and also in our larger neighborhood, we find that this partnership with Mozambique would be a great opportunity. It is not just that India would be benefited, but Mozambique would also be benefited, because Mozambique does not have enough resources to invest in infrastructure development within that country. And India's support in terms of developing infrastructure would be extremely important. Some of our finest engineers and our best agencies are now in place in Mozambique to support this initiative. In last 2 years, this has been consolidated to a very great extent, and this supply would ensure larger availability of resources for our energy security.
South Africa is a member of IBSA, BRICS, G20, and also BASIC countries. How do you view the prospects and the road ahead for both the developing countries?
The important dimension of India and South Africa's partnership is very important in terms of IPSA, India, Brazil, South Africa. Both India and South Africa share a very strong tradition of democracy. In Brazil, at this point, internal debates are on, but IPSA is extremely important. India is chair for BRICS. We would be hosting all these countries here. And then, of course, Prime Minister would be meeting President Zuma at G20 meeting in the first week of September. So from that point of view, I think this meeting would be extremely productive in terms of India and South Africa to evolve common perspective. And of course, would be a good opportunity to catch up on NSG-related issues after what happened in South Korea.
In fact, I'm glad Sachin mentioned about G20, because we've been talking a lot about BRICS. Of course, we are eagerly waiting for the BRICS summit in India. South Africa has been a very important partner for a long time. Now, unlike some of the other African countries, which India had tended to slightly ignore, if ignore is a good word, but South Africa has for a long time been a very important partner for India's economic relations in G20, in WTO, in the context of agriculture in WTO. And Sachin has written extensively on G20 and how the formation of G20 itself was basically an effort by India and South Africa. So relations with South Africa are critical for India.
Professor Chaturvedi, in overall Mr. Narendra Modi's visit to Africa, how do you see this, you know, first visiting Mozambique and then moving on to South Africa, then to Tanzania, then to Kenya? I mean, this movement from one country to another country, it could have been the other way around also.
I don't think that if much has to be read in that, but I think important part is that our Prime Minister has given this message, what he did when we hosted the India-Brazil-South Africa summit. And in that IFS3, it became extremely clear that Prime Minister is extremely keen to support and be partner with this economic development process and make Africa a partner in India's own growth story. So leveraging external sector for domestic economic growth is Prime Minister's very clear, emphatic idea, and that he has been exploring. The only change that we find is to bring in the dimension of culture, trade and economy, all the three together. So from that point of view, I think overall message in terms of engaging Africa in this process and also trying to bring in the major partners, because if you see, most of our development activities are in Kenya and in Mozambique. Our president was in Africa just a month ago, and President Mukherjee visited several of the African countries, 4 of them. So in total, 8 have been covered, and our vice president was in the North Africa. So that way, in last 2 months, all the 3 top functionaries of this country have been to African continent, giving a very strong message of India's continued commitment and appreciation of this relationship. And from that point of view, I think it's very important to see a role that we are expecting South Africa to play. And Prime Minister's visit today to South Africa and to President Zuma is extremely cordial, extremely warm. And I think South Africa would play an important role in reviving India-Brazil-South Africa, but also to play an important pivot in G20 and BRICS.
So there are a number of, so to say, the achievements in Prime Minister's visit to 4 nations. It was a pleasure talking to both of you.
You were listening to a discussion on Prime Minister's South Africa and Mozambique visit. The participants were Professor Sachin Chaturvedi, Director General Research and Information System for Developing Countries, Malancha Chakravarti, Observer Research Foundation, and Samrat Bandhopadhyay, AIR correspondent, who initiated and moderated the discussion. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. You can also listen to this program on our website, newsonair.nic.in. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.